MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 6 of the National League Championship Series between the San Diego Padres and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, obviously, a lot of things still up in the air as we get ready for Game 6.
Yeah, you see the results through the first five games. It's been everything we could have hoped for. And now, at 3-2, you've got a team coming in here that needs to win the final two games on the road to take the series. Going to be a tall order to fill, but I think they're as capable as anyone to pulling it off.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Clayton Kershaw will do the pitching with a trip to the World Series on the table. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, his last one was good. I'm sure he'd like to pitch a little bit better. Was able to get into the seventh inning. Got a no decision in his last one. He needs to get off to a good start here to try to get him and the team in the win column.
Now to the plate, Trent Grisham. And we are set for baseball here this evening. And now a slider is swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is set down to open up the ballgame.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Standing in now, Fernando Tatis Jr. To 2-2 now. Kershaw is way up there among active pitchers in terms of career wins. He's earned more than 170 of them in his time at the big leagues. Here now the 2-2. Starting to get a bit chilly here tonight. 57 degrees at game time. Pitch. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up, or he can really hurt you.
Striding in is Manny Machado. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Safely. Kershaw now on 1-1.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Falling behind now, 3-1.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm in the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
The 3-1. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. A two-run home run for Manny Machado, his second home run of the series, as the Padres have taken a 2-0 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
And plate now, Eric Hosmer. Fouled off. Still only one out in the inning. And another foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery.
And count 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home. And that's low, ball four.
At this rate, he's going to set some kind of a record for walks issued in a game, or he'll get an early hook. We'll see if he can settle down here and start to find the strike zone, or if he continues to struggle.
Digging in now for San Diego, Tommy Pham. Flares this one over toward first. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
Beggars can't be choosers right there. We love those long darts. Doesn't matter how they come. Jam off the end of the bat, doesn't matter.
So now to the plate, Will Myers. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down. At the plate now is Jake Cronenworth. And the Padres trying to make this first inning even better here. And it's fouled away. Hosmer at second, Pham on at first with two down. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. The 2-2 pitch pulled toward right center field. Betts has a read on it. And that ends the inning. The Padres get a couple of runs in the inning on the two-run home run. Home half of the first coming up from Arlington. It's now 2-0 San Diego. Darvish is charged with keeping their hopes alive on the mound here in the league championship series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Yu Darvish is what you look at when you're looking for an ace. Big, strong guy, came over from Japan, 95 to 97 miles an hour, all the way back from Tommy John surgery, has the curveball, the changeup, and the slider, will throw any pitch at any count, one of the top pitchers in the game. And you'll know early if he's seeing a lot of swings and misses and strikeouts, it's going to be a long day for those guys swinging the bat.
The 1-1.
Hey! Darvish
has compiled over 1,100 innings of work over his major league career and sports a respectable ERA just under 3.50. The 1-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Myers is there to put it away for route number one.
Batting second, that's shortstop, Corey Seager.
Next for the Dodgers, Corey Seager. One out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. A bouncer to the left side, taken in by Machado. Throw on to first will get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. So with two gone now, here's a look at our playoff brackets. And our winner here will get the opportunity to battle the newly minted AL champion Los Angeles Angels, and congratulations to them on winning the American League pennant. Base is empty, two away, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Dodgers down in order. They trail things here 2-0. Now at the plate, Austin Nola. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
For me, this is an important add-on inning here. Their little lead is cute. I like it, but keeping the pressure on, building that lead, that's how you bury someone.
The 3-1 pitch. Lifted into the air to shallow center. Lux ranging into the outfield. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Got it, huh? The pitcher, number 11, Darvish.
Up next, it'll be the pitcher for the Padres, Yu Darvish. And the Padres pitcher behind with a 1-2 count.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Yu Darvish is sent packing for out number two in the inning. In now, Trent Grisham. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. But they're on top, 2-0. Cody Bellinger at the plate now. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
To the plate now, Will Smith.
Ball two.
And he misses, 2-1.
I got 2-1 to count.
Bases are empty, one man out. Two and two to the Dodgers catcher.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Now here's the pitch. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
Every pitcher looks to get off to a good start, and I'd say he's off to a good start. How about the first five batters he's faced? Three of them he sent down via the strikeout.
Muncy.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss there, and it's two and two.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count your favorite. He's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
The 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're still down. It's 2-0. Welcome back. Here's Heidi Watney with a report as we get set for the top of the third. Heidi?
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Thank you, Heidi. Top of the third set to get underway, and up steps the big bat of Fernando Tatis Jr. The 1-1 home. To 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
Swing and a little blooper to center. In comes Bellinger, and it drops down in front of him, a base hit. With that, the inning opens with the Padres getting their leadoff man on base.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy has had a monster postseason so far.
Into the box, Manny Machado. Called strike two. Tatis aboard here at first with nobody out. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's running as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Gotta believe that runner from first is going to be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are going to be moving.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Count remains full. Misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out.
When a guy homers off you early in the game, the last thing you want to do is challenge him and maybe have him do it again. He was a lot more careful with him there.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter. Eric Hosmer worked a walk his first time up. None out, runners at first and second. Guide down the left field line, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Now the 1-2 pitch from Kershaw.
Oh, that's low.
Misses, ball two. He's set, and the 2-2 pitch. Now a swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box now, Tommy Pham. And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two. Next to the plate for the Padres, Will Myers struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
And, ooh, might have thought it was high, but it's a strike. Three and two now.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
Kershaw comes set. Here comes the 3-2. And he struck him out. His seventh of the ballgame, and that ends the inning. Padres leave a pair. They're up 2-0. Leading off the inning, it'll be A.J. Pollock as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. The 2-1 on its way. High and deep down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
So he got him swinging.
A.J. Pollock
retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the third. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. Down low, two balls and a strike. Swing, and this ball is blasted to right field. Nothing's going to keep this one in the ballpark. And that one is gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. And the Dodgers are within a run. It's now 2-1.
There's an old saying in the game. They say solo homers won't kill you. This might be a good time for a mound visit right here. Try and erase those negative thoughts and get right back in the zone. You still have the lead.
Standing in now, Clayton Kershaw. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Explodes as this has popped up. Barehanded at his knees. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag. And this will go down as an E5. As you can see the exasperation on his face. Now back to the top of the Dodgers order. Digging in, Mookie Betts. He flew out in his last AB. Kershaw, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
And this guy's a grinder, fouls off good pitches, and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Fouled away. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Myers going back at the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Here's Corey Seager, 0-for-1 here in the early going.
Corey Seager.
Two and one.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
two out with a man at first. A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. Grisham has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. But not before they answer back here with a solo home run. We're through three here in the Lone Star State, and this is now a 2-1 ball game. And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Fouled off. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, he's really on a roll in the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
Austin Nova popped him up. Smith over to his left, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Yu Darvish, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. A 1-1. Misses for the second ball.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing.
Oh man, was that a hack? He's trying to create his own run support with a swing like that.
And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's running as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type.
We'll have to press pause as that strike 3 to retire the side. Padres down in order. They lead it 2-1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the third baseman, Justin Turner. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Nope.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
The 2-1 home. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Myers on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Can't find his zone there, and it's 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number 2. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. The classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
To the plate now, Will Smith. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. swing and a ball hit out toward right center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. Our score remains 2-1. The San Diego batting order turns over and set to go Trent Grisham. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Chopped weakly to the left. Hard hit ball to second. Fielded cleanly. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Into the box, Fernando Tatis Jr. singled in his last at-bat. The 1-1. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth. Next, it'll be Manny Machado. It was a walk in his last trip. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Three up, three down for San Diego. And they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Welcome back to Arlington. Before we get much further, let's check in with Heidi.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be the imposing power bat, Max Muncy. Set, here's the 3-1. Full count, 3-2. And the payoff pitch. Now Muncy with a swing and a deep drive to right. And it's gone! Solo shot to right center. His second home run of the series as the Dodgers have bounced back to tie this 1-2.
Remember the previous pitch? He couldn't get around on the fastball and was mad at himself. Well, there's nothing to be mad about anymore unless you're the guy standing on the mound wondering what just happened.
Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. And here's a fastball not close as he runs it to 2-1 now. Pollock in front, three balls and a strike.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Short, hit hard. And that's through for a base hit, making 1-for-2 in this one.
He was able to spit on that first slider right there, guys, but he didn't let the second one go. Able to execute and drive the baseball.
In now, Gavin Lux. And he looks at one in there, 1-2. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
away. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And this pitch is popped straight up right around the home plate area, and he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
The pitcher, number 22.
So one gun in the inning here with a runner at first, and up next will be the pitcher Clayton Kershaw. And the bunt attempt will be foul, so we'll see how they want to play it now with two strikes. Here comes the 1-2. Is laid off for ball two. Throw over to first, and he's back easily. Two-two, and he tries to bunt here with two strikes, but he's out.
Now back. Right.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. Flew out last time up. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
As the pitching coach heads out to the mound, I think this is probably just a case of giving your guy a chance to catch his breath, pump him up a little bit, let him know that he's got it under control.
Next up for Los Angeles, Corey Seager. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. The set and the 1-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Pollock on second, Betts at first, two out in the inning. And he fouls this one off. Here's the 2-2. Oh, he leaves that one right over the plate as this is sent high and deep out to right center field. And it is gone, a home run. So a three-run shot to right center field, his fifth so far in this series. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
At the plate now, Justin Turner. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Now here's the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Myers. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. So four runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the two big flies. We're through five here at the ballpark. It's the Dodgers 5 and the Friars 2. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Eric Hosmer. One and two now as that one's fouled off. into the windup and the pitch. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame.
That was a good job tying him up inside on that strikeout pitch. It wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with two strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
Standing in now, Tommy Pham. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Making him sweat out there, the seventh pitch coming up. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder. And he will make the play. Two away now.
The right fielder.
Had a long way to go to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track numbers. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 110 feet to finally bring it in. No doubt in efforts his teammates are appreciative of. Into the box now, Will Myers. Lays off his slider that time, 2-1.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. Padres down in order, and the deficit remains 5-2. Joe Musgrove enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Padres, number 44, Joe Musgrove.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next it'll be the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. 1-1. Pulled toward right center field. Cronenworth is calling for it. One down. Here now is Will Smith. Fouled away. 5-2 is our score here in inning number six. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Max Muncy will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. The 2-1 home. Takes a pitch for strike number two. Five runs on only four hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Is looked at and the count moves full.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're still out in front, 5-2. Corey Knebel is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 46, Corey Knebel.
Now at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. 0-2 for him to this point. The 2-1 will not catch the zone. Ball 3.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Sent on the ground out to second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Next, it'll be Austin Nola. 0-2 for him so far. He's flied out and popped out. Here he comes on a ball and 2 strikes. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Pollock has a read on it. That's the second out of the inning. Brian O'Grady will pinch hit here with 2 outs and the bases empty.
Number 5, Brian O'Grady.
Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. 3 up, 3 down for San Diego. They trail 5-2. Leone Kellogg will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the 7th.
Number 27, Leone Kellogg.
So now here is A.J. Pollock, 1-2 on his line so far in the game. The 3-1. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. The got batter, it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Gavin Lux will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the 3rd inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. 5-2, our score as we play inning number 7. To 2-2 now. Padres are going to get something going out in the bullpen now as a left-hander has stood up to throw.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
And it's fouled away. Good battle here. This will be the 7th pitch coming up. Oh, look out! Hot shot to 3rd, and there are 2 away.
The pitcher, number 46.
Chris Taylor gets the call as a pinch hitter, and he'll get a chance with 2 out and the bases empty. One-one. Swung on and missed, and that's strike 2.
1-2.
Hey, find a way right here. 2 outs. This guy's come in throwing bullets. If he can get this team into the dugout right here with another donut, and they regroup, start passing the.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Dodgers down in order, and it remains 5-2. Kingley has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 44, Tommy Kingley.
And the hit will be Trent Grisham. The 1-1 is in there for strike number two.
One ball, two strikes, Jim.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box, Fernando Tatis Jr. All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Around first, digging for two. And he's not stopping. He wants three. The relay, and it's in time as he's out at third as the good relay gets him.
You talk about perfect execution right there. That took a great relay throw to get him. And any breakdown in that relay, and I think he's safe.
Machado now, and they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, and it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Hot shot on the ground to short. Reined in. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Padres down in order, and the deficit remains 5-2. Tim Hill is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 25, Tim Hill.
Here's Mookie Betts, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-1. Hit sharply on the ground. Scooped up. And there's one away. Here's Corey Seager. He had that big three-run homer in his last appearance. One home.
Hey.
And he got him.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Stepping in now, Justin Turner. And this will be fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Grisham makes the catch to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're still out in front, 5-2. Kenley Jansen comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
74, Kenley.
Eric Hosmer to the plate now. No hits to this point.
They look like they're up against it here. Down three on the road, trying to come back against the closer.
Now the 2-1. Hit in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Ready with another two-strike offering. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Hit on the ground out to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Next to hit, Tommy Pham flew out last time up. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Betts has a read on it. Two gone. Digging in next, Will Myers. And their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Two out, nobody on. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. In line for the victory is Clayton Kershaw, should the lead hold. Now the 2-1. And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight. San Diego down to their final strike. Hammered the other way to deep right field. Back goes Betts to the track. And Tinseltown will be aglow tonight. The Dodgers are National League champions.
Well, they've taken care of business all season long, and tonight was no exception. They've proven to be the best team in the National League. Now it's time to see if they can become the best in the entire game. Celebrate tonight, and the World Series is next. Congrats to the NL champs.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our excellent crew, this is Matt Vasgersian saying so long. You've been watching the National League Championship Series.
The victorious Dodgers, 5 runs on 4 hits, no errors, and they left 1 man on base. For the Padres, 2 runs on 4 hits, 1 error, they left 4 men on base. The winning pitcher is Clayton Kershaw. Credit the save to Kenley Jansen. The loss goes to Yu Darvish. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 59 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.